is still the Buffalo. This is the prequel, so he is already Buffalo the Aftermath Hugh. And that brings us to the second theme of Hugh of the gets the letter and he writes the response. Then there is a laundry note that's broken. You need left job at a grocery store on our way back, and you pick up some cereal and some milk for breakfast. And I said, yes, please, that would be fantastic, thank you. So we dropped by the grocery store. Now let me tell you, in my neighborhood in Manhattan, the largest grocery store is 4 aisles wide. 4. Also, the groceries that one can purchase in said store they were, you know, often less than a measure long. Sometimes they were 2, 4, 8 measures. Maybe Beethoven wrote a couple of 16 measure ones. Rossini wrote crescendos that lasted minutes. And he did so in a very interesting way, and you'll hear it a lot in this opera. He would find a tiny little motif that's very basic and very iconic. A big, strong foundation, a little kernel of a strong foundation. And he would put it in just a few instruments. In one of the arias that you'll hear in Act 1 in this production, it's called Simple Slander. Bazzino's aria. He talks about slander and how it starts as a seed and it just spreads and spreads and spreads and causes destruction. And this is a perfect example of this. He chooses these little motif goes like this.
Thank you.
I just want to bring your attention to the fact that this offer that you're about to see in English is actually a very, very authentic experience. The Barber of Seville was premiered in London in Italian. 7 months later, it was performed in London again in English. 7 months later, it came across the Atlantic to New York, where it was performed in English. It then made its way to New Orleans, where it was performed in French. Makes sense though, right? And then, 6 years after the original premiere, it went back to New York, this time in Italian. And when it made its way back to New York, in Italian, it was the first opera to be performed in New York City, in Italian. Now, we're not using the original Covent Garden translation today because I'd say most of us probably wouldn't understand it. We have a wonderful new translation by the wonderful Kelly Rourke that is modern and hilarious, and you'll enjoy it a lot, I think. Anyway, that's basically all for me. I realize that I'm playing with it with the story, and we're going to tie that up at the keyboard in a second to give you some reason to get you out the door and across to get your tickets. I'll maybe borrow some help from Felix Mendelssohn to give you a hint as to where the story is going. But I wanted to take this opportunity to ask if anyone has any questions. It could be anything. It could be about the Barber of Seville, it could be about the scene, about how we put on an opera, what the milk tastes like in Australia. I don't know anything that you are interested in asking. Please go ahead and use one. I will do my best to answer. Yes? Tell you about my training in Australia and beyond. I have two elder sisters. I grew up in Sydney. I have two elder sisters. They're fairly close in age, and then there was a bit of a gap before I came out. When my two elder sisters, when it came time when my parents thought, well, you know, they should stop using their pacifiers, they took